comme tu book academic center. Book academic center is in Jambuli. Jambuli is a Fula village, and most of the people here speak only Fula.
So the village is a very big village with a population of kids around maybe 40 to 50% of the village are kids, and we could not cater for all the kids because we only have 4 classrooms in the school, and it's really a challenge. Sometimes we reject them because we don't have space, and sometimes parents want to bring their kids but they don't have the token to pay for the school fees. It's really a challenge, and it's bleed our heart that we could not take them because they can't afford the fees. We also have our costs, our financial challenges also, and we also have our budget, because from the school fees is where we take to pay our teachers, and they also have a family. So we are appealing to everyone who have a heart to help kids to sponsor our program of sponsoring a child. The village has a lot of kids, and we want them to come to the school because this is our community and we love our community. We want to change the status quo of this village. We want to have children that are educated. I took over the school and renamed it Hope Academic Center. So we will do what we can in our own small ways, and we want the school to grow big and to affect the community. We ask for gender equality. That is why we want 60% of our students to be female. Where the school is located, the community does not value education because tells the parents about the importance of education and why their children should be educated. It's not their fault because they don't have the privilege to be educated. That is why we talk to them and encourage them for them to release their kids to be educated. We have a lot of children in the community, but most of them don't come to the school. Why? Because we don't have even space for them. With our effort, a lot of parents want to bring their kids to the school, but we can't cater for them because we just have 4 classes. We are appealing that we have the building and the proper materials to take good care of the school, and to 90% of them are housewives, so it's really very difficult for them to have funds for the kids to come. But with that still, most of the kids don't pay their school fees. So what should we do? We still allow them to come to school and take up all the expenses. So most of our teachers are not on salaries. The community has no other school, and the nearby schools are also very far. And another challenge is that those communities will have to take their students first, people in the community, before taking our students. So we are appealing that we have people who can help us, partner or sponsor us to build extra classrooms and fancy school. The school is on a highway, and it affects us because we don't concentrate 100% in class. Our furnitures are very old. Some of them are spoiled, you can see. And we need a lot of renovation here in the classroom. Our blackboards are old, but we can still manage them. So this is one of the classes we have. But as you can see, some of our desks are really very old, and the class needs a lot of renovation.
Because we cannot open the school without not having a fence. So we started with this fence and the forest. So we try to make the fence so that it can be strong. Three sides of the building is done with corrugate because we cannot afford to make a fence with the blocks. So we managed to do this this front part with the blocks, and the rest we use corrugate to. This is the playground. We use old tires and paint them to make playground, and we also have more tires that we can use to decorate the place. All is in progress. Gradually, as we get money, we will try to develop this place and make it beautiful. Because children like colors and they like to play. And as we also educate them, we teach them how to play together. We teach them on teamwork, and this is a very good place that we secure for them to be playing.
These parents, they don't know the value of education. If they happen to bring their children to school, we ask them for school fees, they send them out. They prefer removing the children from school because of school fees.
We have many challenges in this school, but also we are saying thanks to God for having this school, because without this school, some of these children would have just been like sitting at home doing nothing. But we thank God that the school is here, and it has been providing a lot. Many of these children in the village has been coming. Like the children, some of them are there, paying school fees is a problem. Some parents, they don't know there are many things. If we name, we can't finish them. So you can see we have a lot of problems, like chairs, tables, school materials. They are all our problems.
Michelle has stepped in with the team to make sure that they bring light, they bring hope to the people of that Jamweli community. So we believe that Hope Academy Center is a project that we need to invest into to show that at least these young ones have a better life.
And as you also watch the video, we pray that God will touch your heart so that you can do what you think is right for the school. And one thing that we say is, if you help a child, you are helping a future, a leader. We don't know where that leader will be.
Keeps turning round, and lift your hands up to the sky and say it loud and proud.